Hey everyone, welcome to Plants and Politics. So there is some Jim Jones level stuff going on right now, and it could end with deaths just as it did with the Jonestown cult. This is getting really concerning. Last week, Lynn Wood said this at a Stop the Steal rally in Georgia. Take a listen.
Remember this part of that declaration. We pledge to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor. And most of them lost their fortunes. Many of them lost their lives. But they did it for their children and their grandchildren and the generations to come, because they did it for freedom. It's our time now. Pledge your life, your fortune, your sacred honor to keep this country free.
So you hear, he essentially called for people to sacrifice their lives to keep Trump in power. He literally said that you should give up your life, give up your money. Okay, then this week, the state Republican Party in Arizona retweeted a post from Ali Alexander, and I'll explain in a minute who he is. And his post read, quote, "I am willing to give my life for this fight." Now he's referring to this fight, which Donald Trump keeps losing in court because he has no evidence to prove any kind of voter fraud. So the Republican Party of Arizona, the official Republican Party Twitter account, retweeted that, and they added to it the phrase, "He is, are you?" Meaning he's willing to give up his life, are you? These people have lost their minds. So Alexander, as I mentioned, he's the far right conspiracy theorist who launched the whole Stop the Steal lunacy. And I mean, they're all sounding like they want you to throw yourself on a landmine for Trump. This is insane. And then they additionally, on top of doing that, which that tweet is apparently still up, but they deleted another tweet where they posted a clip from a Rambo movie with the caption, quote, "This is what we do, who we are, live for nothing or die for something." Die for Donald Trump. Die for a con man who doesn't give a damn about you and is proving it right now, because he hasn't given a damn to lift a finger or say a word about helping Americans right now when all aid is about to end the day after Christmas and 2 weeks after that, and people are on the verge of being homeless. I mean, and at any other time in history, we could all assume that this is just hyperbole and that the rhetoric will die down eventually, Biden will get into office, and, you know, people are going to finally get it. But, you know, we're dealing with tens of millions of Americans right now who are fully vested in Trump's lies about voter fraud. Even in the absence of actual evidence, and I think it's up to like 50 court losses, they still believe him over everything else, over every judge. The Supreme Court just slapped him down, said, nah, yeah, we're not going to take up your case. And they turn on these people. Oh, they're part of the deep state. These were people he nominated. These were people that they all cheered for. And now they're saying they're part of the deep state because they won't go along with his lie. Not to mention, we already have increased acts of violence that we're witnessing throughout the country, right-wing plots to kidnap and murder politicians. This seriously could become a dangerous situation. I'm going to out myself here and tell people how old I am with this comment, but I used to watch The Brady Bunch growing up. I loved that show, never missed an episode. And this reminds me of when Marsha and Jan and Cindy and Mrs. Brady, they were all out building their own little clubhouse because the boys had one and the girls wanted to have one because the boys never let them in. So they're building one and all the guys are inside and they're laughing and joking and making fun of how incompetent they are, unable to build anything. And it's all so funny. And then all of a sudden, one of the pieces of wood falls and it almost hits Cindy. And Mike Brady says something like, "This isn't funny anymore." You know, this very dramatic moment. And they rush out and then they help the girls build their own clubhouse. That's what this reminds me of. We've all been laughing. We've all been watching from inside going, look at these idiots. Oh my God, they're such fools. And now it's not funny anymore. It's past the point of being comical. And anyone out there who tried to compare Bernie supporters like myself to the MAGA crowd owes us a huge apology. First of all, most of us bit the bullet once again and voted for Biden and helped him win. But never once did a Bernie supporter call for his voters to sacrifice their life to get him elected. In fact, liberals were angry at Bernie supporters for not going along with his decision to back Biden in the general election. Remember that? So we're clearly not cult members. You know, after years of calling us Bernie bros and a cult, we prove liberals wrong by actually having minds of our own. There's no comparison between the two groups. And you also have people in positions of power. And this is, I think, what's making it even worse and more dangerous. People in positions of great power on the right going along with this insanity, and news outlets like Newsmax and Weitbart and OAN, they're going along with these outright fabrications, which makes it all the more believable for the MAGA crowd. And I make the distinction between Trump supporters and the MAGA crowd because I happen to know and love some Trump supporters. I don't agree with them. I wonder what they're thinking, but they would never in their life be caught dead in a MAGA hat or at one of his rallies. There is a difference between those who believed in and supported his policies, but they don't necessarily care for Trump himself. And even then, some of his policies were a big turnoff and they didn't like them, but they were willing to overlook those for some of the other things. There's a difference between those type of people and those who only care that he pisses off the right people and love the fact that he's an arrogant piece of shit human being. Anyway, guys, in the words of Mike Brady, this isn't funny anymore. It's getting dangerous, and I see this ending badly. I'll let you know if I hear anything else. As always, like, share, subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and listening. I'll talk with you soon. Take care. Thanks for listening to Plants and Politics. The only way we can take our country and power back is to spread the truth and build an army. So remember to like, follow, subscribe, and share on Facebook, YouTube, and wherever you listen to your podcasts. Thanks again.